What's up, Adorama fans? My name is Cooper Natove, and I'm a DP and director based right here in Brooklyn, New York. Today, I'm super excited to give you guys a quick overview of Sony's brand new ultimate run-and-gun camera, the FX6. We're also going to go over Sony's new 16-35 T3.1 servo zoom. The FX6 was super exciting for me to get to play with because I'm a longtime FS7 owner. Camera technology has come a long way since the FS7 was released in 2014, and all the new features in the FX6 make it a super tempting upgrade. The FX6 is the smallest in Sony's cinema camera lineup, with the body coming in at just under 2 pounds. That's 2.5 pounds less than the FX9. This makes it super easy to operate with the side-mounted hand grip, as well as on gimbals and drones. The FX6 packs a brand new 4K 10.2 megapixel back illuminated sensor capable of 15 stops of dynamic range. It also has a dual base ISO of 800 and 12,800. Usually shooting high frame rates and low light is a real problem, but with the new higher base ISO, it's not a problem at all. All these new features are made possible by Sony's brand new Bionz XR processor. This new processor packs 8 times as much processing power compared to the previous model and allows for higher EVF resolution, more codecs, and more frame rates. To speed up the navigation process for all these new features, Sony has finally added a high-detailed touchscreen monitor. The new monitor is super sharp compared to my FS7, and I never found myself wondering whether my shot was in focus or not. While I think this camera will live in Cine EI mode most of the time, custom mode is available for the people who don't want to spend a ton of time in post. If you're wanting to bake in a look, you can use a 3D LUT of your own, or you can use Sony's new S-CineTone profile. S-CineTone was designed to have a slightly flat filmic look while beautifully rendering skin tones. If dynamic range is what you're after, the FX6 offers 2 different HDR shooting modes while in custom. HDR shooting modes are all well and good, but if you want to get the most dynamic range and color correctioning ability, you're going to want to shoot RAW. The FX6 is capable of outputting 16-bit RAW and 4K up to 60 frames a second via SDI. Should you want to, the FX6 will let you simultaneously record RAW through SDI and XAVCI to the internal card. Speaking of cards, the FX6 has 2 slots for media. You can either use 2 CFexpress Type A's or 2 SD cards. The difference is you can only record the highest frame rates on the CFexpress Type A's. Another really nice touch is the included all-aluminum card reader. It's super sturdy compared to ones I've used before. With Sony's new cinema camera lineup, they've taken an entirely new approach to image stabilization. Instead of trying to actually stabilize the sensor itself, they're inputting stabilization metadata right into the clip. Then, using Sony's free Catalyst software, it uses the metadata to accurately stabilize the footage. It's so much better than Warp Stabilize. At the beginning of this video, I said the FX6 is the perfect run-and-gun camera, and I really mean it. Let me elaborate. First of all, the FX6 barely even needs a cheese plate. The included touchscreen monitor has 9 different mounting locations all throughout the camera. As I mentioned before, this is a dual native ISO camera. What I didn't mention is that the ISO goes all the way up to 409,600 ISO. I'm not sure I would spend that much time at such a high ISO, but I can't wait to see the stuff you guys shoot with it. One of my favorite things about this camera is the wide array of frame rates. In 4K, you can shoot all the way up to 120 frames a second. If you need to go a little slower, in 1080, you can go all the way to 240. Something everyone is really gonna love on this camera is the stopless electronically variable ND. You can dial in the perfect exposure smoothly from 0 to 7 stops of ND. The electronic variable ND on this camera is so much better than the one on my FS7. Before, I found myself having to compromise with exposure or depth of field, and now I can just dial it right in. Normally, you'd never be able to transition between 2 different lighting conditions mid-shot, but with Sony's new automatic ND, it's not a problem at all. Shooting sound on the FX6 is no problem. No tiny adapters are necessary because there's 2 full-size XLR inputs right on the handle. Your editor is going to love you for shooting on the FX6 as well because there's a timecode input right in the back. I know I've been using the term favorite a lot when I talk about this camera, but my favorite feature is the ridiculously good autofocus. Never in a million years did I think I'd be using autofocus on a cinema camera, but with autofocus this good, I don't think I'll ever have to use manual focus again. There are several different autofocus modes on this camera to shoot in. There's standard, face and eye priority, and face and eye only. In the standard autofocus mode, the camera's gonna focus on whatever spot or zone you've designated in the focus menu. In face and eye priority mode, the camera's gonna search for a face in your frame. If there's no face though, it's just gonna focus on what's in front of you. In face and eye only mode, the camera's only gonna focus on a face in frame. If there's no face in frame, it's not gonna change focus. My favorite way to use autofocus on this camera though is very similar to the way I shoot stills. I set up one of the assignable buttons on the grip to push AF. That way, the camera only focuses when I push the button. Sony has made failed rack focuses a thing of the past with this camera. All you have to do is use the touchscreen monitor and click on whatever you want in focus. You can even dial in the autofocus sensitivity so it's easy to control the speed of your rack focus. Now let's talk about Sony's new full frame 16-35 T3.1 servo zoom lens. Compared to the FX6's body, this lens is a beast. With the 16 elements and 13 groups, this is one of the sharpest lenses I've ever used. While T3.1 might sound a little slow, most lenses you're used to labeled F2.8 are probably closer to T3s anyway. The 16-35 also has dual floating AF groups and direct drive SSM linear actuators for super fast and totally silent autofocus tracking. If you're not into autofocus, no worries. This lens also comes equipped with focus gears just like their other servo zooms. The lens itself also has several switches to dial in your shooting experience. It has an HL switch on the bottom to control the servo zoom speed, a WT switch to control zoom, an iris lock switch, as well as a click and declick switch for the aperture. Personally, I love having the iris lock. Being able to lock the aperture in place is so important so you don't accidentally change your exposure mid-shot. Most of the time when we're shooting video, we're using lenses that were actually designed for still photography, and this brings in a phenomenon called breathing. This lens has been designed for video, so there's minimal focus breathing, ramping, or axial shift. I think this lens is perfect for the person looking for a full frame, wide angle servo zoom that also wants to utilize its lightning fast autofocus capabilities. With its full frame sensor, high frame rates, small size, and ridiculously good autofocus, I think the FX6 is truly the best run and gun camera I've ever used. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and please let me know if you have any questions in the comments. See you next time.